Hello and welcome to Driver's Therapy. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the ASE A2 test, and that's going to be automatic transmission and transaxle. And I just took this test. What I always try to do is do these videos right after I took the test. And guys, the emotions are everywhere. First off, this was a hard test for me. It was quite intricate. But second of all, this was my eighth test with the ASE series. So guys, I'm gonna make a whole video about it, but I passed, so that means that I am officially a master tech, an ASE master technician, and this is awesome. It's been a really long journey. I'm really excited. Now, if you guys are just tuning in, this is a video series. I've made a study guide and advice video for all the tests. So this is one of them, but I just quickly wanted to know in the timeline of this thing, this was my eighth test and I accomplished the mission and I'm super excited because it was a lot of hard work. All right, so without further ado, let's go ahead and just dive in. So if you guys are taking the A2, you can learn. All right, this time around, what I did is I got two types of study guides. I got the Del Mar study guide and I got the Motor Age one. The cool thing is in the future, I'm gonna be making a video comparing them. But if you haven't been keeping track, I've been using the Del Mar study guides for all of the tests. And this is the first time I bought the Motor Age. And just real quickly, there's a big difference in them because this is pretty much a practice test study guide. In my opinion, this is how I'm referencing it. And this is pretty much like a book of theory of operation and just talking about it almost in layman terms. I like their voice and everything about the subject. So it was very helpful. So this test is hard. For me. Now, I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just trying to be honest. It was when I left the testing center, I was pretty sure I didn't pass, but I did it. So essentially, if you think about the automatic transmission, I know I thought of it this way. It's pretty intricate. It's not like your normal manual gearbox. It's got a lot more going on because it's got to do something. It's got to take the responsibility of what the driver would be doing, manually shifting. It's got to do it, but it has to do it in a way that it's precise, efficient, effective, and just longevity of the component itself, so reliable mechanically. So essentially what I wanted to do was, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I have not played with an automatic transmission. Now, the Supra is an automatic and I love it, and it's a really great car, and I think the transmission is one of the best ones in my opinion, shifts nicely. But I never turned to an automatic transmission. And before this test, I would have been like, I'm not touching one. But what I did is I spent a lot of time beating in the theory of operation, also really trying to understand every nook and crevice in an automatic transmission. It's pretty much a big city in there. You've got valve bodies, you've got little channels, you've got solenoids, you've got also your traditional stuff like clutches, and you've got gears and all that. So really what I'm gonna recommend you guys do is first understand how an automatic transmission works. Now, this wasn't as easy as the manual transmission as far as finding information. I actually had to gather it from all over the internet. The Motor Age is probably the one that helped me out the most of understanding how that worked. But long story short, you're gonna wanna see an automatic transmission opened up. So go on YouTube and I'll put a couple links that I did, and you're gonna wanna see how it looks inside there. Now, before you dive in there, remember theory of operation is key. So while you're looking at that, you're gonna wanna watch a video of how the transmission works. When you watch that video, it's really not gonna help you. It's gonna be very foreign to you. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna wanna see it broken down. And as it's being broken down, you're gonna run into those planetary gears, which I actually am a big space junkie, both Elise and I. And so when I found out that there was a gear set called planetary gears, it was really easy to learn because, you know, you have a sun gear, you know, you have your ring gear and you have your planet gears. And I thought that was pretty cool because somebody finally named something the way it kind of looks like. So inside an automatic transmission, you're gonna have a planetary gear. You're gonna wanna understand how that works. It's pretty straightforward, it's a cool design, but you're gonna wanna know how that works because that's a big thing. Another thing that I found out that no matter what video, no matter what rebuild video, teardown, is you're gonna wanna understand how a clutch pack works. At first, it's gonna seem really odd, but once you understand it, it's pretty simple. Essentially, it's just a drum. You know, drum, think of it, you know, almost like a cup. I know it's not a best analogy, but it's a drum. And inside there, you're gonna have your clutch packs. And your clutch packs essentially are alternating like plates, and then a plate with friction material, clutch friction material, plate. And essentially what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna understand how to put together that clutch pack and how to take it apart, understanding the clearances and the nuances of putting it together. Now, one of the biggest things right away I'm gonna tell you is like one of the key things you're gonna run into and you're gonna wanna learn is like on the clutch pack, and we're talking about, you know, the automatic transmission here, just so we give you the topic overview. That clutch pack, like before, if you're putting it together and it's brand new, you're gonna wanna soak in transmission fluid, you know, for about 30 minutes or so. So that's like one of those key things that you're gonna learn while you're learning about the transmissions. Another thing you're gonna understand is that as you see multiple automatic transmissions disassembled, which you're gonna have to see, you're gonna start realizing the main components, like the clutch pack, the torque converter, the valve body, the planetary gears, the bow housing, extension housing, all this stuff will become second nature to you. But one of the biggest things you're gonna wanna do, in my opinion, is break down the automatic transmission kind of in three areas. Now, this is just my take on it. The torque converter, the valve body, and then the gear set, like planetary gears and the clutches. So in those three areas, you're really gonna wanna understand a lot about it. So the torque converter is its own subject. First off, people think manual transmissions are cool. Let me tell you, a torque converter is super freaking cool. I didn't know this, but the Koenigsberg doesn't even have a transmission. It uses like a torque converter technology, which they name it differently, but it's exactly what it is. If the torque converter looks so neat, if you're just typing Google like torque converter cut in half, it's a really neat design. I think it's pretty cool. It's like an engineering feat, and I mean, it's just really neat. But you're gonna understand what a torque converter does, how it works, and there's so many videos that could help you understand how that works, which is really neat. So you just type in how a torque converter works. So understanding the torque converter, the stator, and also to when a torque converter has a clutch, and understanding how that works is really gonna help you out. So some of the things I'm saying seems foreign to you, maybe, but trust me, it's all gonna come into place and you're gonna do fine. So once you understand the automatic transmission, how it works, and the components inside them, what they do and how they operate, now, in my opinion, you're ready to study. I know it sounds a lot of work, but it is what it is, guys. So at this point in time, you can have your study guides. And what I did is, again, this sounds repetitive if you've been watching the 7 other video series on this, but I take my 6 tests, and then whatever I'm getting wrong or whatever is very foreign to me, I do a lot of research on it. I take notes. And then this time around, what I did is while I was doing that on my free time, I was reading. This is very different. The motor rage breaks down the components and the areas of the topic a little bit more as far as reading digest. So I was using these two things, and then in the same time I was watching somebody tear down an automatic transmission and then rebuilding one. Sometimes it's hard to watch these videos because they're long, but what I did is I found a secret way how to make it interesting. Take a car you really like, maybe one that you really want, and make sure it has an automatic transmission, and then watch somebody disassemble the transmission on a car that you really like. It makes it a lot more interesting. So what I did is I watched videos on the Supra and I watched them tear down and stuff like that. So it was both study, but it was also applicable to kind of the car that I own. So I hope that piece of information helps you out study a little bit better. But what I did is as I went through that process, I started realizing that there's a lot of troubleshooting and diagnosis with the automatic transmission. And that's probably one of the parts that was the hardest for me. Now remember, I cannot tell you what's on the test because I could get in trouble. But what I could tell you right now is that you want to, one of the biggest things that I'm gonna tell you as far as everything as the test goes, is you're really gonna wanna understand a range chart. That's all I could say. And what that is, it's just a chart that shows, they call it diagnostic chart or flow chart for an automatic transmission. And what it does, it shows like in this gear, this solenoid will be on, this solenoid will be off, this clutch will be on, this one will be holding. And you're gonna really wanna understand how to read that. Guys, trust me, you wanna know how to understand a automatic transmission operations flow chart, whatever they wanna call it. Second of all, you really want to understand diagnosis as far as slipping, harsh shifts, slow shifts, and then any vibrations or thumps. So pretty much you're going to want to know why an automatic transmission might slip and what components will cause that. You're also going to want to know why an automatic transmission will shift hard. Two things right away, it's going to shift hard. If the pressure sensor is disconnected, it's going to boop, it's going to send this pressure all the way up. Or if an accumulator spring is damaged or not working, it's going to cause harsh shifts. Simple stuff like that. Or if your band on your clutch pack is loose, you know, you could cause slipping and burn the fluid. I mean, all this stuff starts making sense, but that's where the theory operation is going to help you, is by knowing when you read something, why something causes something, you're going to be like, well, that kind of makes sense, because if this is turning and if it's not tight, it's going to do X, Y, and Z. So essentially, my goal is to be a guide for you to pass this test. Understand the automatic transmission. Know the inner workings of it. Know all the components and what they do and how they work. Watch them be disassembled and assembled. Understand the clearances, the thrust washers, dial indicator, what you're taking a measurement and when you're using a dial indicator and why you're using it. Understanding the clearances, fluid types, coolers, and stuff like that as far as the automatic transmission goes. Once you understand all of that, then you're going to want to start using your practice test so you can get topics of areas that could, you know, help you study more. I'm going to recommend a Motor Rage book so you could actually read more in depth about those components from a book that is geared to teach you to understand automatic transmissions and their associated troubleshooting, diagnosis, and theory of operation. And then at that point in time, you're just going to want to keep taking tests and understanding how that works. My only biggest thing is understand that automatic flow chart. Know how an automatic transmission works and if you need to diagnose it in case you're having some slipping or if you're skipping gears or a gear's not working or if it's dying or the engine's dying and gears and blah, blah, blah. This test is very broad and I am very impressed of how, you know, the when I took the test of, impressed is not a good word because that's a positive word. I was a little stressed out about how broad this subject is compared to the other subjects. So automatic transmissions are tough. Know how a CVT transmission works and a dual clutch transmission, just the theory of operations. And I would do that at the end so you could understand because they're a little more complicated. So you can understand how the technology was derived from an original transmission and then go from there. I know this is a long video, guys, but I want you to pass. I hope this information helped you out. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. My email is on the about on the channel. Welcome you to subscribe so you can keep track of the channel. Also helps us out, supports the channel growth, and also lets you know when we post a new channel. Well, you guys stay safe, take care, and best of luck in your AAC journey.